Hello everyone, welcome back to your physics class. I hope you all are well. In this video, you will learn about force of friction, the daily life examples of friction, what is the cause of friction and the properties of friction. You might have observed a rolling ball comes to a halt or it stops after moving certain distance. And a toy car needs continuous muscular or spring force to keep it going, otherwise it stops moving. And when you pedal a bicycle, the bicycle keep on moving, but whenever you stop pedaling, it gradually slows down and finally comes to rest. The reason behind this is the frictional force or the force of friction. So friction is a type of force that comes into play whenever a body moves over a surface, or it acts between two surfaces in contact and opposes the motion of one body over the other. As you can see, the motion of the car and the frictional force are in the opposite directions. So, friction opposes the motion of the objects and it acts in a direction opposite to the direction of the motion. Here is an example which shows that friction opposes the relative motion, means the motion between the two surfaces. As we know that friction exists whenever two objects are in contact with each other and when one object moves over the surface of another object. Like in this case, a wooden box is kept over the floor. So the surface of the wooden box is in contact with the floor. So whenever a person tries to push this box or to move this box, then he experiences an opposing force because the surface of the box and the floor are in contact with each other. So there will be frictional force which will act in an opposite direction to the direction of motion. This is the direction of motion. So this will be the direction of the frictional force. As the direction of motion and the direction of frictional force are opposite to each other, so it confirms that friction opposes the relative motion between the two surfaces. It is harder to move an object having more mass because of the gravity of Earth acting on that object. So it would be difficult to move a heavier object than a lighter object when friction comes into play. Next is some daily life examples of frictional forces. First is a football when kicked come to rest on its own on a ground due to friction. A football moves to a certain distance, gradually it slows down and finally it comes to rest because of the force of friction between the surface of football and the ground. And the blades of a moving fan comes to a halt. They stop on their own after being switched off due to friction applied by the air and the parts of the fan. Similarly, a car comes to a stop when brakes are applied. So these brakes actually exert a frictional force on the wheels. That's why car comes to stop. And as we have learned earlier that when we pedal a bicycle, it moves. But if we stop pedaling, it slows down and finally it comes to rest. So this is due to the friction between the wheel and the road. Next is cause of friction. As we know that frictional force comes into play whenever the two surfaces are in contact with each other and one surface moves or slides over the other. According to old view, the cause of friction is due to the presence of irregularities in the surfaces of the objects. If we see the surfaces at the microscopic level, then all the surfaces have irregularities. Even if they appear to be smooth, just like a plane table, it appears to be smooth, but it also have some irregularities in its surface. These irregularities can be easily seen if we look at the magnified image of the surfaces. Here you can see the irregularities at the point of contact of the two surfaces. These irregularities are present in the form of projections. These are the projections and depressions in the surfaces of the objects. So whenever the two surfaces come in contact with each other, then the irregularities interlock. So the interlocking of the irregularities of the two surfaces cause the friction between the surfaces of the objects. So friction depends upon the presence of irregularities or the roughness of the surfaces. Hence, roughness or smoothness of the surfaces of objects in contact determines the strength of the force of friction.
smoother the surface, lesser will be the frictional force. So this is the reason that we tend to slip on a wet floor, because wet floor offers very little friction and it makes us difficult to walk. And rougher the surface, higher will be the friction. So that's why it is harder to drive a vehicle on a bumpy and a rocky road. Next is properties of friction. So the first one is that friction is a force that always acts whenever two surfaces come in contact and one surface moves or slides over the other. Second is that the force of friction always opposes the motion. It always acts in the direction opposite to that of the direction of motion of the objects. So it slows down the motion of the object or stops it. Next is different solids experience different amounts of friction on a surface. Means on the same surface, the different solids will have different amount of friction. For example, if we take an ice cube and a cubical rubber object, then out of the two, an ice cube will experience less friction because it is smoother than the cubical rubber object. And solids, liquids and gases can all exert the force of friction on an object which is either moving over them or through them. And the force of friction also generates heat. For example, whenever we run any kind of machinery for a long time, that can be a sewing machine, the engine of a vehicle or a food processor, then it becomes hot. So why this becomes hot? This is just due to the friction between the various parts of the machinery. So friction leads to wastage of energy in the form of heat. Next is friction can also lead to wear and tear of the objects. For example, the soles of shoes wear off after some time. So why it happens? This is just because of the friction between the road and the sole of the shoe. Similarly, the tires of the vehicles wear off after some time. This is due to the friction between the tire and the road.